Charlie Parker Lake, though, from both of you. Yeah, but yeah, I mean, it's just a matter of more listening. That's all. You guys are competent. You guys are great, great players. So, you know, listening and learning solos from the great guys, not from the great guys, is really going to make a big difference. I mean, if you guys want records, I can send you records. That's not a problem. I have a big online database full of records that I've sent all my students, and I'm more than happy to send you guys stuff. So just, you know, put all the names and email addresses on a sheet, and it's not that hard. The hard part is playing with a group and improvising. The charts are easy. The songs are simple songs. Making music out of simple songs is the hard part, and that's the part that I think that defines great jazz players. So those are some of the things that I do. I have two groups of students when I teach. The freshmen come in. There's that really, really small percentage of people who believe that you might be right, and then the other ones who just nod their heads and they're not going to listen to you at all. And then 6 weeks in, there's this sudden realization that one or two people, their sounds have changed and their approach has changed because they've actually been listening to the recordings and the other guys have not been listening to the recordings. So the guys who haven't been start looking at the other guys very quizzically, like, what have you been doing to suddenly get better? And the guy says, oh, I've just been listening to those recordings that Branford told me to listen to. And with students, you listen to the music, and I've done it with all of my, man, I've been listening to this song, you know, for hours and hours every day. I said, really, sing the bass line. What? Oh, you haven't been listening. Okay, well, come back when you've listened. Because, I mean, there's so many things in one recording that it could take you months to figure out. So a lot of my students, unfortunately, think that I would be impressed by volume, when actually I'm just impressed by specificity. If you can learn one song and tell me everything that is happening in that song, that is super impressive. point of jazz is that jazz is supposed to be small group jazz. At its core, is conversational. And it can't be a conversation if you have five different people talking about five different things at the same time. And a lot of times, that's what's going on. Listening, it changed the way that I heard the music. So I think that you have to think about music in general. There's more to music than just going in the practice room and working it out. I mean, if the older you get, you notice that people can be moved to tears by music. And the thing that moves them is indescribable to them. So clearly, it's not something you can work on in a practice room. This is a place that you have to figure out a way to use sound to create an emotional context. And that's how you retain listeners. That's how you get a 30, 40-year career.